Hello. Yes, nice to see you. Nice to be here again. And thank you very much. Thank you for watching my videos. Thank you, all of you that subscribe to my channel. God bless you. I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus that not only that you subscribe, but you will always know the truth, and the truth will always set you free. This is my purpose, and this is my joy that you subscribe to the channel and always pick something that will bless your life, that will direct your life in the way of life, in the way of righteousness. This is the reason I always say subscribe, so that you keep on receiving something that the Lord is saying, something, the new direction, the new move, the fresh dreams and the revelation that God is giving. So it is important, so that if you truly love God, love to live a life that is worthy of Him, you can also subscribe and always receive a new video to know what God is saying. All right, so Nigerian people, I want to talk to you for the coming election that is coming next year, 2019. I have something that I want to tell you, what God have revealed to me about the coming election. This time, God, because God, our God, is interested in the affairs of men. God is the owner of the nation, owner of the nations of the earth. And if the church do the right thing, if the church of Jesus Christ is under the authority of Jesus, the church supposed to control each nation, any true man of God that God put in a nation is to direct the affairs of men, direct the earth authority. Anytime evil is coming, a true man of God have to see it, arrest it, and destroy it. This is the reason the church, God, but then the church is the highest authority. Okay, now I will be guiding you now concerning what God said about coming election. I had a revelation God gave to me about Obasanjo and Atiku. Obasanjo and Atiku. So I will go ahead and tell you now, so that you can get it very clear. I was in the spirit. God took me to Obasanjo house. So I came inside this house. I saw Obasanjo and Atiku. They sat down on a dining table. They sat down and they're eating. In the plate is a big, they put fish. Fish is all that is in the plate. So they're eating. So I step inside. And that room is filled with darkness, thick darkness, thick darkness. With God's spirit, the highest spirit. So I can see through. I can see everything very clear. So Obasanjo and Atiku was eating. And what they are eating, what they put on the table that they are eating, is fish. As they are eating the fish, I step my feet. As I look inside the food, that two of them is eating. From fish, it changed to meat. So I just drew near. Two of them shifted, give a gap. They give gap from where they are and move towards the other room, the next room that is near the dining table. So, but what marvels me in that revelation is that Atiku is not wearing cloth. Atiku was naked. But Obasanjo was wearing cloth. Two of them enter into one room. And I said, what are they doing? And the darkness in this house is a bungalow. It's a bungalow. The darkness was great. So God's spirit began to minister to me. He said to me, why is it that anybody that want to be Nigerian president, If that person did not go down to Obasanjo or be in romance with Obasanjo, Obasanjo will be against that person. I see him as husband and wife. Obasanjo is the husband and the Atiku is the wife. Why are you naked? Are you guys homosexual? Why are you naked? Atiku, why are you naked? So you are in romance with Obasanjo so that you can be able to get to Asorok. For you people to keep on spreading darkness in that nation. But the joyful part of it is that that food that they cooked, that they prepared, that they're eating, was spoiled. Heaven spoiled that food. That food was spoiled. I told you that they're eating fish. The fish changed to meat. But heaven, the Almighty spoiled the food. Because that food that they cooked, that they prepared, that they're eating, warming up, have been spoiled. Why is Atiku naked, Obasanjo wearing clothes, and two of them enter into one room, into a bedroom together? So Atiku is wife, Obasanjo is the husband. So that when Atiku enter into power, it will not be Atiku ruling the nation, but Obasanjo ruling through him, through Atiku. Nigerians beware. Nigerian youths beware. These are the enemy of Nigeria. Hey, Obasanjo, I'm talking to you. It's still me, that young boy that stop you from going third term when you are in power. That stop you. I'm still the one talking. If nobody can see you people and talk to people, the Almighty have opened my eyes, have taken me to you people, and I've seen everything. And I have to talk. I have to speak so that the Nigerian youth and Nigerian people will know that there is nothing good coming from Atiku and Obasanjo. During the time of Jonathan, you messed up the whole thing when Jonathan refused to be your wife. You messed up the whole thing. You brought out PDP card and membership card, and you tore it in the name to show your anger that Jonathan refused to be your wife, so that you'll be the husband, the one controlling. This is what caused Buhari to come into power. And you feel the heat. You feel the heat because you are no more going to Asorok or doing things the way you're supposed to do, because that one is another thing altogether. So now you are now cooking again. You are cooking a fresh dish. You are cooking a fresh plan that you want to continue from where you stop. No way. It cannot. I said again, remember, the young man that God used to stop you from going third term in power, I am still the same young man talking. I'm still the same man talking. By the Spirit of God, by the Spirit of the Most High, I'm talking to you. I saw Obasanjo, you're contouring power, your influence, authority over that nation called Nigeria have expired. Enough is enough. You are seriously serious. I see you as the enemy. Nigerian people, listen very carefully. How can Obasanjo be the one that will always assign somebody that will rule that nation? How can somebody like Tinubu be the one that will be picking up somebody that will be ruling a whole great nation like Nigeria? You have to prove them wrong now. Prove Obasanjo and the Tinubu wrong, that they are not the one that's supposed to decide the destiny of Nigerians. They have been doing it and it is not working. Why can't you say no to that? Why can't you Nigerians say no to that? Vote for the person that you know that this person is a different person from the one that Obasanjo and the Tinubu is picking for you. Are they the owner of Nigeria? Are they the one that will be determining and deciding the future of Nigeria? Say no to that. They are preparing a thick darkness that they want to spread in that nation. Votes to PDP or PDP or APC is still the same. It's still the same darkness. It's still the same evil that is going on. Say no to all these things. Let there be a change, real change now in Nigeria. If you people did not heed to my voice or to my advice or to what I'm saying, you think I'm saying my own. I am telling you people what the Almighty revealed to me. He took me in the spirit to Obasanjo's house. I have seen it all. The same way I said it before Buhari came into power, I was shouting and crying and telling people, see what I saw. See what the Almighty showed me. That this man is coming to punish Nigerians. People did not heed, though I was not in YouTube then. But now I am saying it for people to hear. There is nothing good that is coming out of PDP or APC. Nothing good. Nothing good. If you can heed my voice now, it will do Nigerians, it will do Nigeria good. If you people can hear my voice for what I'm saying, I see evil. I see thick darkness. How can Atiku be naked and the two of them is in one bedroom? Guys, I do not understand what they are doing there. But what I want to tell you is that enough of this evil. Let us say no to evil. Yes to good. Nigeria people, I want you to say no to evil and yes to good. I have said what I want to say for now. Be wise. I said it the way I saw it, the way God revealed it to me, the way I saw it, I said it, I didn't add, I didn't remove. Be wise and let us change. Let there be a change of game. We need another pattern. We need a different formation to play the game now. If we have been playing 4-4-2, let us play 4-3-3. 4-4-2 is not giving us the answer. Let us change formation to beat the opponent, to beat the evil, to knock evil out of Nigeria. God bless you as you hear this and spread it to people to hear and know. What is going on before next year? Obasanjo have nothing to offer Nigeria. Obasanjo is just evil. With Tinubu, they have nothing to offer Nigeria. So all that they are cooking and doing secretly is evil. Evil upon evil. But God is seeing them and disposing them. And God said that, no, if you know that you have suffered enough, you can join me and say no to evil in that great country called Nigeria.